Hello, I'm Susan Guthrie, America's Divorce Innovation Specialist, and today I'm going to do another in my series of frequently asked divorce questions. So these are some of the top Googled questions that people look for when they are facing divorce. So today's question is, what is an uncontested divorce? And that's a good question because you're going to hear that quite often as you go into the divorce process, and that is because the vast majority, and I mean vast, majority of cases go forward on an uncontested basis. So what does that mean? So really, at its core, what uncontested means is that all of the issues in the divorce are resolved, and there's no contest or there's no argument about how everything is going to be resolved. So really, the uncontested divorce refers to the situation where you and your spouse have worked out all of the issues in your divorce. You've come to an agreement. The agreement has been reduced to a writing, usually called a separation agreement or a marital settlement agreement or some type of agreement between the two of you that outlines all of your agreements and understandings. And when you have that, you can go to court before a judge. Now, some states you need to go in person, other states you just submit the paperwork. So that will depend on where you are residing and where you're getting your divorce. But when you have everything all worked out, the judge at that point in time usually just has to make a determination that the marriage has broken down irretrievably. That's in a state that's a no-fault state, so where just one or both of you have agreed the marriage is to end. And then all of the issues that arise out of your divorce, property settlement, issues around the parenting and custody of your children, and support issues, where those have all been worked out and put into an agreement, you can go forward on an uncontested basis. I recently read a statistic that said that approximately 95% of cases go forward uncontested, meaning that in some way those two people found a way to work out all of those issues. Now, that's usually done through either negotiation, which can be done directly between the two of you one-on-one, or more often is done by your attorneys handling the negotiations for you. That can be rather expensive because you're paying your attorneys, you know, one-on-one to go and negotiate those things for you. Another way that many people do that is through mediation, where you and your spouse are one-on-one, but you're working with a mediator, a neutral mediator, who's there to help you facilitate. Which means to identify the issues, to know the law around them, and then to discuss them so that you can come to a resolution. So the alternate of an uncontested divorce is a trial. So when you cannot come to resolution for those 5% or so of cases where the parties, for whatever reason, cannot come to a resolution, that's when you're going to have a trial. That's where you're going to go into a courtroom and the man or woman in a robe, the judge, is going to make determinations, make rulings about all of those issues. So the judge will decide who gets what, who pays what the parenting plan's going to look like, what's in your children's best interests, who's paying what for support, who's paying what for college, if that's something that is allowable under the law in your jurisdiction. The key difference there is you're making none of the decisions, the judge is making all of them. And the reason why so many people do come to resolution, or one of the key factors, is because it's never an ideal situation to have a third party who doesn't know you and doesn't know your lives make all of these very important decisions about them. So I urge you to do what you can, find a method. I always recommend mediation. We at Breaking Free Mediation work with people both in person and online to help them facilitate their agreements. But I do urge you to find a way to come to agreement with your spouse so that you can move through the process and you can go forward uncontested and you don't need a trial where that a third party in a black robe is going to tell you what to do. So to find out more, please watch some of my other videos on YouTube, or you can visit my website, divorceinabetterway.com. Thank you, and I'll see you soon.